friends, so today we are going to talk about Spring Web Client's timeouts. As we discussed in the previous section, till the web client configuration, there are two ways of applying timeouts. One is at the request level, at the individual request level, and at the other one is at the via HTTP client and through for global configuration. When I say global configuration, we can do it at the configuration level. So here we are going to both the ways. So we are going to do it with HTTP client here. So this is our existing code which we have seen in the previous tutorial, that is part one. In part one we have created one get web client method, and currently that get web client method is simply instantiating the web client through builder. So now in this tutorial we will be adding connectors to it, and we will be configuring the timeouts for that. So yeah, so that's pretty much of it we are going to talk about in this session. So fasten your seatbelts and enjoy the ride. The server back and to check our functionality whether it is working or not. So let's give it a try. We are going to hit the all comments URL. Oops, we got some error in the backend. Let's see what error we are getting here. So it seems, yeah, it says it's saying something about the URL which we have passed. So let's see in the code also as well. Guys, we have identified the issues. Basically, the code which we have written, we missed this base URL statement here. So because of this we were getting, because we have since we have not passed any URL there, so due to that it is saying unparsable URL. So that's the issue. These things happens at times. We miss small things and issues or errors comes on top of that. So yeah, and apart from that we have refactored the get client method also, get web client with timeout method also. We have moved the whole HTTP client part into the method itself instead of passing that as an argument. So yeah, we can see the method here, as it's been shown here on the screen. So with that, let's bounce back the server and see whether timeout works. So basically, if the timeout works, we should be getting an exception about related to the timeout. And for this testing, for this tutorial, what we have done is we are trying to give the minimum timeout. Default timeout is 30 seconds, but we are trying to give it very, very less timeout. So now let's check the backend. What exception we got? Voila, we got the exception related to timeout. So here ends the tutorial, and we have seen here how can we check the timeouts. So there are, as I mentioned earlier, there are two ways of mentioning timeout. One is at the individual request level at the web client itself, and the other is adding the timeouts in the HTTP client. So this get web client with timeout method is doing that HTTP client way, and the other one is at the web client level also. So that we have done in the one of our service method. So you can check that as well. So now we are reverting back to some reasonable timeout. We are giving it as 10 seconds. So now we should get the response in 10 seconds, otherwise timeout exception will occur. So let's bounce back the server and see what exception, whether we are getting the exception or whether we are getting the response from the JSON placeholder endpoint. Refreshing the page and let's see. So, yep, we got the data this time with the reasonable timeout configuration. So if you like our work, subscribe to our channel and support us. Thanks for watching. Until next time, bye bye.